We continue now at the top of Daf Nun Chesam and Beis Masechah Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 58b. The Gemara here is in the middle of a brisa talking about the tumah of various kinds of bells. So the Gemara says Vishel Delas Tahora. The brisa says rather that the doorbell, a doorbell would be Tahor. Rashi explains Delas Mechuber Labayisu Shuchibur Lakark. Essentially, it's attached to a house which is attached to the ground. Ve'eno Kli Lakabil Tumah. The principle is that something that is mechubel karka is not considered a kli, it's not mekabel tumah. Vizuka asi lo batel gabe, and then of course the bell that's attached to the door is going to be batel to the door, which is mechubel lakarka. Kedamin reish pirkin de la'el kol mechubel lo arei komo. Anything that's attached to it takes on that halacha. Shel delas vasola behema. The brisa continues. If you had a doorbell that you then decided to convert to use for a behema tumei, it would actually become tumei. Shel behema vasola delas. Now, if you had a bell that was made for a behema and you decided to switch it to a delas, aval pi shechibra ledelas, even though you attached it to the delas, the kavu masmerim, and you affixed it with nails, tumei would still remain tumei. It doesn't matter. Shekala kalim yordin lidei tumasan b'machshava, because the principle is that all kalim become tumei through machshava, that you thought to use it for a particular purpose that made it tumei. Ve'ein olim lidei tumasan, and they don't leave that tumah ela b'shinoi ma'isa, unless there's a shinoi ma'isa, meaning there's a change in the item itself, which you don't have in this case. So in any case, the problem over here is, are bells going to be mekabel tumah or not? We have a contradiction in brisa. So the Gemara says, lo kasha is not difficult. Had de isle inbol, had de lesle inbol. It depends if the bell has inside of it the piece of metal that's going to make it ring, or if it's not going to, if it's not able to make a noise. That's the difference. If it's able to make a noise, then it's going to be tumah, and if it's not able to make any noise, then it's not tumah. So the Gemara says, manavshach. Either way we look at this, it doesn't make sense. Imanhu, if this item is considered a vessel, a utensil, or you could say an ornament, afalpi de lesle invol, then even if it doesn't have the invol, it should be tame because it's an ornament. And ilavmanhu, if it's not an ornament, if it's not a utensil, invol mashvile mana, what, you're going to put the invol in there, and then all of a sudden it's going to be considered a utensil? So the Gemara answers in yes. Kid Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni Yomer Rav Yonasan. It follows what Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni said in the name of Rav Yonasan. Da'am Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni Yomer Rav Yonasan, because Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni said in the name of Rav Yonasan. Minayin lemashmiya kobekli matches shutame. How do we know that if you have metal kalim that make noise, that can make them tame? Shenemar, like it says, kol davar asher yavo be'esh taviro be'esh. It says any item which was originally put in the fire, you have to put in through the fire in order to, this is talking about kasher and kalim, but we make the following drasha. Afilu dibor yavo ba'esh. It means to say, even something which makes noise, that is enough to require that it's yavo ba'esh, essentially to say that it in fact becomes tumah. That alone, the fact that it can make noise, can make it be mekabel tumah. The Gemara says, b'mayo kimta b'lesle invol. Now the Gemara says, how can you say that this whole part of the brisa that's talking about bells for animals is talking where there's no invol, where there's no clapper, where it makes no noise? If that's the case, ema mitziyasa, let's go back to the middle case of the brisa, the bells that are attached to humans. It says velo bezug shebetzavaro. It says that the eved should not go out with the bell that's around his neck. Avol yotzeu bezug shebichsu. So he's allowed to go out with the bell that's affixed to his clothing. Vezev is mekablin tumah, and it said it is mekablin tumah. Now, e de lesle invol be mekabel tumah. Now, if it has no invol, do we really say that a bell is mekabel tumah when it's for a human? But uramin, we have a contradiction. It says ha'osa zogin lemachteshes v'la'ariso lemitpachos svarim v'lemitpachos tinokos yeshlem invol tumeim elam invol tahorin. These are various kinds of bells. So you're making it either for arisas where the baby is sleeping in the crib, so you have a little bell there to help him sleep. Sometimes you also have bells when the children are coming, that mitzpachos sofrim svarim, they carry svarim to the Beis HaKnesses, they'll have some bells, mitzpachos tinokos, also for babies, not just for the crib. All of these different cases, the halacha basically is, if it makes noise, then it's tameh, and if it doesn't, then it's tar. And then it says, nitlu invalei, and adai in tumasan aleim. If the invol is taken away, they still remain tamei as they were originally. So the problem over here is, it seems pretty clear from this brisa that when it comes to bells for people, it does need to have the invol. So the Gemara says, "Hani mili betinach de lekala avidile." This brisa, what does that have in common? All of these bells were for children. Those kinds of bells are never ornaments. They're always made just for noise purposes, and obviously, therefore, they need to be able to make noise. Aval gadol tachshit hulei. But when it comes to an adult who's wearing this bell, that's always considered an ornament. Afal gav de lesle invol. Therefore, even though it doesn't have an invol, it is still going to be tame. Gemara now quotes the Braisa, Amar mar nitzalu invalei and adayin tumasan alein. It says that if the invol is taken away from these various items, we're talking here about the bells for children, so the halach is, it's still tame. So the Gemara says, why is that true? Lamai chazu. What is it fit for? The halacha generally is that if a kli is changed and it has no use anymore, so then it loses its status as a kli and it's not tame. So in this case, where you're taking away the invol of the bell, so it has to have some kind of use in order to remain in its tumah state. So the Gemara says, Amar Abaye, Abaye says, Hoel shahed yachol lahachziro. Since a person who's not an expert is able to return this, it's easy to fix. So then it's as if it was never taken away, and it remains tame. So the Gemara asks, Mesiv Rav, Rav asks Abaye, says, Hazug vo'invol chibor. It says the zug and the invol are considered attached, meaning when they are attached to one another, they're considered one kli. So if one component would become tame, the other component would become tame. Similarly, if you're going to be metahir, you have to be metahir the whole thing. It's considered one keli. So that's the halach. It's considered chibur. So if it's considered chibur one keli, so then at least at first glance, we should say that when it gets separated, then it's no longer going to be one keli. If it's one keli when it's attached, then when you separate, it's no longer going to be considered a kli. It's going to be considered a kli that was broken. And v'chi teima hachi ka'amar. Now, if you're going to say that what this braisa means is as follows, afa gav de lo mechuber kemand mechuber dami, that it doesn't even need to be attached, and it's considered as if it's attached, and it means exactly what Abaye was saying, that's not true either. V'atani, we learned in a braisa, mispora shal prakim v'zamal shal rehitni. This is talking about if you have scissors, or you have a carpenter's plane, so these have different parts that are attached to each other. Chibur l'tumah v'ein chibur l'hazah. So the halach is it's considered attached to become tame, meaning that, you know, again, only one part of it has to become tame for the entire thing to become tame. But when you purify it, it's considered two separate things. You can be metar separately. V'amrina, we say on that b'raisa manavshach. Either way we look at it, it makes no sense. I chibur hu afil l'hazah, v'lo chibur who I feel it's an amilo. If it's considered attached, then even for purification purposes, it should be considered one item. If it's not considered attached, then even to become tame, it should be considered two separate items. Why would you make a distinction between tuma and tahara? The Amar Rabbi, and Rabbi answered, Dvar Torah b'shas melacha chibor bein l'tuma bein l'hazah, that midoraisa, when you're actually working with the item, it's considered one unit for all purposes, whether tuma or tahara. Shelo b'shas melacha, when you're not working with the item, eno chibor lo l'tuma v'lo l'hazah, then it's considered two separate items, whether regarding tuma or hazah, it's never considered to be one unit. And all of this was, and the reason why we make a distinction is we're always machmir. They made a decree when tumah would happen, not during the work time, it's going to be tumah just like it's tumah when it's while you're working with the item. And the other way also, by purification, they said you got to purify them as if they're two separate things, whether you're working with them or not. You have to be strict. So in any case, what you see from all of this is that items that can easily be put together and taken apart on a doraisa level, they are considered separate if they are separated, and they're considered put together if they're put together. You can't say that when the item was taken apart, you can't say that it's as if it's still put together. So the Gemara will answer, Elo Amar Rava, rather Rava says, and we'll see Rava's answer in the next video on Daf Nun Tes Amud Aleph.